Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Thank you, Chairperson, for introduction. I'm very happy to be here with you today. I know that two days are so heavy and so stressful for you. Inshallah, my talk will be, I expected that many universities will precede me, so I tried a lot to reduce my slide. So unfortunately, or fortunately, I don't know what is good or bad, that the deviation for education, for everything, even social support is very important. But the data on our children are still not that good, even worldwide, because the burden of quality of life is maybe a new term or something like that. So we need, inshallah, to stress on the quality of life for every disease, but we will concern today our concern about the thalassemia. There was a lot of introduction, so I shortcut the introduction. طبعاً, all of us know the burden of thalassemia. Oh, not here. I'm sorry. طبعاً, we are in the Eastern Mediterranean, so beta thalassemia, the carrier rate up to 18 in some locations or some region in Egypt. And the alpha thalassemia, Dr. Muhammad Salah agree with me a lot that alpha thalassemia is there, but we don't diagnose it thoroughly. This is a very big issue. طبعاً, hemoglobin H disease and similar diseases طبعاً, are there. So it is not only beta, but also check alpha thalassemia. The definition طبعاً, of quality of life by WHO is a state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being, and not merely the absence of the disease. For thalassemia, طبعاً, as any other disease, understanding of the psychological and social consequences should accompany an awareness of clinical burden. They all contribute طبعاً, to the state of well-being of this patient. In spite of advances, طبعاً, Dr. Muhammad Bashir said, alhamdulillah, that everybody is receiving chelation therapy. Everybody is receiving a clean blood, a good blood. Maybe now we have not testing, but still something wrong with our patient. Why is there something wrong with our patient? We have good chelation protocols. We have good blood transfusion protocols. So why is still our patient is suffering from poor quality of life? I wish, inshallah, from today, inshallah, everybody will concentrate on the quality of life of his or patients. In spite of the advances in the care of thalassemia patient, the survival rate, patients still suffer disease complications like transfusions and chelation complications, and the burden of like dosage and link to the subcutaneous infusion or admission and so on. Hence, the preservation of good quality of life is one of the major targets in the clinical management of thalassemia patient, which was assessed طبعاً, and highlighted in different studies, but still very little. I tried to do variant study that is started with India. They said that thalassemia is a disability and extremely stressful for the community. All these studies are on the teenagers. Pakistan also said parents are highly concerned. This is the conclusion of the aspect of quality of life in their children. 2010, Thailand, there is significantly affected by child according to the age of diagnosis. Saudi Arabia, deterioration of quality of life, especially in physical and general health. USA, painful. It is a painful disease, guided by cultural beliefs. Jordan, lowest school functioning and physical functioning domains among thalassemia patients compared to healthy patient. In Brazil, there is increased working capacity in teenagers and later on young adult. In Egypt, Dr. Alfi in 2014 said there is an emotional problem, especially the patient is the problem of stigmatization of the differentiation. The patient feels that it is different from others. And in Emirates, they compared the two studies between 2011 and 2014 and found that there is some improvement. So we need to, inshallah, when we conduct the quality of life survey to our patient, we will try to improve later on, as I will conclude in the last slide in the session. طبعاً, a lot of factors like the impact of diagnosis on the family and the family dynamics. طبعاً, you know that طبعاً, most of the family who's carrying the burden is the mother. And I know a lot of divorces, unfortunately, because the father is not willing to help the mother for transfusion and coming to hospital and even for everything. So the family dynamics will be disturbed and will affect the quality of life. طبعا it's a chronic condition. All of us agree that is a chronic condition. Even patient who is transplanted also will continue to be monitored forever for the growth for endocrinal, for even secondary malignancy or something like that. The appearance of the child with age, there will be some deformities with some short stature, some hypogonadism, and he will feel a very poor self-image. This is very important, really. The treatment frequency of hospitalization, transfusion, circulation, the طبعا with teenagers, the absence of secondary sex character, complications like heart failure, heart disease, liver disease, and now also we have renal disease also, Dr. Mohammed Bashir mentioned. Uncertainty about the future. Shall I will die and I will not get married and I will not be having work, I will not be employed. So we have to concentrate. This is to shortcut this area. The aim of our study is to assess the quality of life among the children covered by Mansoura University Children's Hospital. The main objective was to study the impact of thalassemia disease as a disease on physical and psychological activity of the child. So it was a cross-sectional study. These are the tools, very important tools. And yani, pardon me if I just one slide, I will have a little time on the slide. Not this, the next slide, inshallah. Tool one, first, is to check what about the knowledge of the patient and the mother or the parent about thalassemia. What do you know about thalassemia? What do you know about your disease? Very important, really. What do you know about thalassemia? What do you know about blood transfusion? The importance of blood transfusion? What about the chelation? What is the chelation? Why we are giving you chelation? And so on. This is very important domain in the knowledge. The second tool is the quality of life inventory version, which consists of the 23 items. 8 items according to physical functioning, 5 emotional, 5 social, and 5 school functioning. I will buzz this one, okay? But I will come back in the tables. Okay, this is the inventory, pediatric quality of life. Inclusion criteria, طبعاً, all of them are beta thalassemia measured, diagnosed and followed up with pediatric hematology and the oncology unit of Mansoura University Children's Hospital. Between 6 to 18, طبعاً, when baby can, the child can يعني, negotiate with us and they can answer questions, simple question. And the patient who are severely ill, we exclude it from the study. And the patient who and the parent are unwilling to contribute in the study also, we exclude them. Statistically, when we calculate sample size by the statistical department, they found that it is enough to have 124 patients. So they are recruited from the outpatient clinic, and we have assent from the parents, and started على بركة الله through a 1-year study. It was conducted by the Faculty of Nursing. It was a thesis for master degree. By the way, our work was a thesis of master degree, طبعا approved by both ethical committee in Mansoura and Bursaid universities. The result, طبعا this is a distribution, just يعني those simple demographic data. يعني maybe the majority was between 8 to 12 years, and يعني the distribution is more or less even distribution. Male and female also are the same. The school, يعني طبعا because يعني most of them below 12 years of age, they were mostly in the primary school, not in the prep school and the secondary. But fortunately, all of them were in the school, not escaping from the school. This is good news, by the way. most of them are coming from rural area, from Mansoura, and you know Mansoura is one of the delta. Qahliya is one of the Delta governorates. Most of the inhabitants are rural area. Most of them are from crowded family, and unfortunately, not enough family income. It looks like a demographic data of poor person. What about the first domain, as I mentioned, the knowledge? Unfortunately, there was 80% of the children don't know what is thalassemia and what are these diseases. They are having a problem, necessitated blood transfusion, that's all. This is very serious, by the way. This is like an auditing. We are auditing our work. We are auditing our care of the patient. So it is not good to have no idea about thalassemia up to 80%. What about the importance? Yes, they agree that it is important. What about the chelation? Yes, it is important. But why we are using chelation? They don't have enough information to know what is the burden of iron overload if they don't if they are not compliant to the chelation therapy. And what about the suitable nutrition? This is a different situation. We are not maybe equivocal that to keep on suitable nutrition or not. The bad news is the mother also are not good. They are also not all of them are aware of the disease. So about 42% are not aware of the disease. What is thalassemia? They are the mother knowledge. They know that chelation is okay, but also equivocal. We don't know why we are using chelation therapy. This is why there is a lot of poor compliance. They are not linked to chelation because they don't know why they are using chelation therapy. And also, unfortunately, because of the poor income, they don't know also what about the to link to suitable nutrition. Unfortunately. This table is summarizing the result. And so I know I don't need to have more time. The coming slides will be there for young researcher free to have my presentation. But this is a summary of our work. We found that more than 80% of patients have high and moderate physical, alhamdulillah, to some extent, physical quality of life. But emotionally, 50% have a moderate. Nobody, very little was high quality of life in the emotional domain. For the social domain, it is okay. More or less 60% is functioning well socially. And unfortunately, moderate school quality of life. But the overall score of quality of life is moderate, 42%. And the coming slides are just showing to you what are the questions: difficulty walking, difficulty running, difficulty making activity, difficulty lifting heavy things, taking a bath by himself or need somebody to help him, doing showers, which is household work, like girl or some boys also, feeling pain, tired quickly. Yes, we have a lot of them. You can see that here. Maybe 100% is tired quickly. But because of the distribution of the age and the other calculation, we found that it's a moderate. Here also, in the physical domain, we have a lot of complaining. Difficulty walking, the previous one, the previous one was a younger age. And this one with an older age. Still we have a complaint in the physical functioning. Emotional functioning, also, we have a disturbance. Almost always complaining to be afraid, to be sad, to be angry, to have sleeping trouble, to be worried for his life, and so on. And this table shows that with younger age, the social functioning is more or less okay. But with advancement of age, and because of the change in the physical appearance of the child, there will be a little bit withdrawal. You can see here, from here can conclude that in early age, less than 12 years, it's okay. Once he is teenager, he start to have a problem, social problem. But we are, because of the data, statistically not significant, but we can monitor this changes. The same here also in the social functioning, school function also, it was the social, this is the school functioning. In early, there is never have a problem in the class. Later on, they have a problem. I'm sorry for these circles are not coopted to the number, and so on. The correlations, we have to try what is the correlation. There is positive correlation with child age, child education.